Hey y'all, welcome back to the Hawken News. I have another new guest host with me today who will be featured on two more shows after this.
I'm so glad to be here. Thank you. My name's Liz.
Liz has been one of the pivotal people that works in the back to make this show look really good. But before we get to announcements, everybody, you know what time it is. It's time for you to stand up and pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you, everybody. And while you're getting settled in your seats, Liz is going to let y'all know what's happening with our announcements today.
Alrighty, Hawks. Today we have Black History Announcements, Spirit Days, Student Athletes, UAF applications, and a grand new edition of The Man in the Hallway.
Alright, y'all. It's February, and February is dedicated as Black History Month, honoring the triumphs and tribulations of African Americans throughout U.S. history. And it is, in fact, day 9 of the month. As I informed you last week, we will start the show each day of this month by doing a fun fact for each show. The fourth fun fact of the month is that in 1870, Hiram Rhodes Revels became the first African-American male elected to the U.S. Senate. He used this opportunity to continue to fight against the Reconstruction era of racial discrimination. You know, Liz, speaking of great achievements of people throughout history, can you let us know about the students who are killing it in the athletics department?
The Fairbanks alumni chapter of Delta Sigma Theta is hosting a Black History Month program next Saturday, February 18th. It'll be held at the J.P. Jones Community Center from 10 a.m. to 1 p.m. It is $10 admissions for staff and secondary students. There will be pancake breakfast, and the program consists of Black historical figures presenting Black historical Black Greek letter organization information. You can go to facdst.org.
Alrighty, Liz. I have to shine some light on our impressive athletes that I mentioned earlier. Aiden Fogg Anderson has moved past the preliminary JROTC rifle competition, will be moving on to the finals in Ohio. Congrats to you, Aiden. Dylan and Tyler Skaggs took silver medals in the Arctic Winter Games in Alberta, Canada this past few months. Great job to all of you. Keep up the good work. Liz, I think you have some more exciting news to share with us, right?
I do. Everybody, we have a brand new Spirit Week coming up next week. Monday is Just Got Dumped Day, so wear your pajamas. Tuesday is Valentine's Swag, so wear pink, black, red, or candy heart shirts, anything that relates to Valentine's Day. Wednesday is to be determined, so we'll keep you posted on that. Thursday is Valentine's Day assembly, and the class colors, freshman colors is silver, sophomore is white, junior is blue, and senior wears black. Friday is twin day, and twin with anyone from school, movies, books, as long as you're twinning. I hope to see everyone participating in next week's Spirit Day. What is HOSA doing for Valentine's Day, Layla?
Well, Liz, HOSA started selling Valentine's candygrams Wednesday, February 8th, and will go on to Monday, February 13th. You can buy your candygram during lunch in the Commons. They will be delivered during the extension period on Valentine's Day. So buy some for yourself or your significant other or your friends. I mean, the possibilities are endless. If you have any questions or concerns, you can contact Ms. Eilers for more. What's going on this week with Man in the Hallway?
Man in the Hallway this week, I went around asking people to say the first word that came into their mind with each letter of the alphabet.
Sounds interesting. Let's check it out.
Yeah, dude, I'm a dude, we're all just dudes. Ow!
Alligator. Balloon.
Cartographer. Donkeys.
E. coli. Fishy!
Gone. Hi.
Igloo. Jungle. Kick.
Lazy. Muffins.
Name. Ostrich. Pinocchio.
Quietus. Reason.
Sure. Thermonumalescence.
Umbrella. Viana!
Xylophone. Zebra.
That's all for this week's Man in the Hallway. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.
It would take me a while to think of all those words with those letters.
Yeah, while I was filming, I skipped a few letters and had to go back and film. Layla, didn't you say something about UAF applications earlier, though?
I did, Liz. And that's because it's coming up tomorrow, Friday, February 10th, everybody. Sam Urban, the UAF Admissions Counselor, will be here to provide assistance to seniors applying to UAF. Students applying to UAF, if you attend and complete the application, you will not have to pay the application fee. This event is also open to juniors who would like to learn more about UAF by speaking directly to the admissions counselor himself. It will help you get your foot in the door. In order to attend, you must sign up with the link on the graphic shown or scan the QR code shown as well. I hope to see a lot of you there. Birthdays, see who to celebrate.
And with the depressed birthdays, let's get in the mood.
Happy birthday to Brianna Burroughs, Israel Griswold, Dania Hassler, Olivia Tucker, Michael David, Jaden Laird, Chloe Wittenculler, and Lauren Hanley. I wish you all a very happy birthday. I don't know why I'm using this mic, it doesn't even work.
That was something new. I need to sit in a happy light. Happy birthday, though.
Happy birthday to all of you guys. But Ian just really just puts a damper in my mood. I go from happy to depressed myself.
Hawks, the week is slowly ending. Remember to send in your TikToks. This week's challenge is to make me laugh. Anything appropriate and funny can help you to get your Class A free root beer float. The more people in the TikTok, the more... Seniors are on their way to get a free root beer float party. Freshmen, you need to step up your game. March 9th is the last day to submit your TikToks. March 10th is when we will be providing the free root beer floats to the winners. Remember, if you don't want to post your TikTok on your account, you can email it to us at hawkhitnews@hawkhitnews.com. That was a lot for my first show, but we got through it.
Liz, you did an amazing job, and I cannot wait for more shows with you next week. Until next time, Hutch.
Bye!